I want to talk to you today about something that maybe you have dealt with and I have dealt with in my walk with the Lord. Right away, I dealt with this, and that was fear. I mean, it came at me really strong, and fear to the point where I couldn't talk to anybody about the Lord. It was very hard for me. And I don't really remember growing up. I was in church all my life, but I don't really remember having any kind of a teaching that told me that I needed to be sharing my faith with someone to tell them about the Lord Jesus Christ. So I went all my life not knowing that that was something that I needed to do. And I was saved at an early age, and I met my husband at an early age, and we got married. Now, one thing you have to know about myself is I was a Christian, but my husband was not. And I believed that if I just waited a short while, my husband would eventually be saved. But that short while ended up being 19 years that I had to pray for my husband to be saved. Well, my husband not only got saved, he got radically saved. And right away, I noticed something in him. He started talking to people about Jesus, something that I had not been doing. And I was observing him. And the first reaction I had was to be jealous of my husband. Well, who does he think he is? I should be doing that. And here he is doing something that I thought I should be doing, but really didn't realize I should be doing. So immediately I realized, well, this is not the right thing for me to do, so I needed to repent of that jealousy and ask the Lord to forgive me of that jealousy. Well, my husband ended up having a rare blood disease, and the Lord miraculously saved him and healed him from that disease. And so he's going out and speaking as he's being invited into churches and Full Gospel Businessmen's meeting and sharing his testimony, his story, about how God saved him and how God healed him. And as I'm sitting under the Word, I'm beginning to see something else happen. I'm beginning to hear messages about sharing your faith with other people. And so again, I'm coming under a conviction and realizing I'm not doing what I'm supposed to be doing. And so I needed to hit my knees again and repent now for knowing I haven't been obedient to share my faith with people. And so I said, Lord, you know, I'm saved all these years. My husband's only been saved a short while. He's out there telling everyone about you, but I am bound in this fear. And Lord, I need you to help me because I don't want to live like this. I want to be set free from this fear that's keeping me bound. I mean, it was paralyzing. It was like my mouth was just taped shut. That's how it felt. And it was a heaviness on me. And so as we're going out and we're traveling to churches and we're talking to the people about the Lord and talking to them about being a witness. And I felt like a hypocrite because I wasn't doing it. I was hearing the message. I was being convicted, but I wasn't doing it. And I felt wrong. It felt just all wrong for me. But I cried out to God to help me because I really wanted to be set free. And you know, God heard my cry. He heard my prayer. And I remember one time we were in the state of Louisiana, and we were actually there to minister some of the things that I have been sharing that we were doing, telling people how to be a witness for the Lord Jesus Christ. On the way to the service, I wanted to stop in this convenience store to get a bottle of water. And, you know, we've been talking to you about different forms of media ministry. And at that time, I had a cassette tape with me. And I used that as a point of contact. And I, you know, sat it down on the counter there as I was paying for my purchase. And I asked the lady a question. I says, you know, if you were to die tonight, would you go to heaven or would you go to hell? And the lady says, I don't know. And I said, well, before I leave here, would you like to know? And she said, yes, I would. And so I shared the gospel with her, and we got to pray together, and she asked the Lord to be her Savior right there as we were talking. And I was so excited that finally, you know, my breakthrough come. You know, I had prayed and asked the Lord to help me with that fear. And the neat thing is, you know, God moves when he decides to move and how he decides to move. And I didn't know when it was going to come, but I was pouring my heart out, crying that the Lord would set me free. Well, when I got back in the car to head to the church, I was excited because it felt like an anvil had been on me all those years, and then it was lifted off of me. And so I couldn't contain myself anymore. And I just said, hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus, because he set me free. I was so excited. And then I looked at my husband because he was driving, because I thought, oh my gosh, you know, he doesn't know this is coming out of me, because I'm thinking this man's going to end up in a ditch because I am excited. I just let it go. But you know what? I just praise God for that because he set me free. You know, I didn't do it myself. Jesus set me free. And as he set me free, I know he can set you free too. And as we continue to lift up Jesus, and we continue to have him help us, we can be set free every day, and we can use the different types of media ministry that we have to reach those in the world that we come in contact with. And I'm just praising God, because even though he set me free, fear still tries to come. But I have to always go back to repenting and asking the Lord to forgive me and saying, Lord, next time I want to do it better. I don't want to mess up. But when I do, I want to be able to repent and ask you to forgive me. And I want to be able to have all my tools with me wherever I go, so I can be ready to tell someone about you, so they have the opportunity to receive you as their Lord and Savior.